As you start to detail your design, you will have to think of a product structure, and the good way to do it is to design at the right level of detail. But how to decide how deep detailing should be? In fact, it's all about the value. A preliminary model of the building will be used to count the number of windows of each kind, and a simple representation of every window as a part is enough for this. But a window manufacturer will represent it as a parametric assembly of parts, as each part has a cost to produce. If you can't decide between a part or an assembly, just create a part that can be replaced by a product later on. The other way around, you can turn a product into a part using derived representation. For a construction model, the product decomposition reflects the spatial organization. This viaduct is composed of two viaducts and a bridge. The bridge is made of two towers and the deck. And the deck is composed of segments where you will find plates, etc. To create a product structure compliant with IFC standard, use AEC types. To create a tower, for example, instead of basic product, use tower type. Right-click on the type label to fill properties at creation step for this specific type. Change its name. Add another AEC type below it like this. If the tower is a part, use this option. But be careful, you can't insert any type below any other. For example, a site cannot be instantiated below a tower because it's meaningless. The table of compatibility is available in the documentation inside this Excel file. Use geolocation to locate items on the globe. It's handy when you need to aggregate geolocated data. Geolocation is set on the reference and computes the position matrix of a child under its father that also needs to be geolocated. That's why a geolocated item somewhere in the product structure will require that all parents above are geolocated too. If the parent product isn't geolocated, like in this case, click here to geolocate it according to the child geolocation and relative positioning. The other way around, if the parent is geolocated and the child has a relative position to it, like we are doing now, the geolocation can be computed and set on the reference by clicking on this label. If your model is bigger than a kilometer, use large range option. Most of the time, site and terrain should be modeled in large range and building in normal range, under a model of same or higher range, but not the other way around. You can create an external reference to a geometry of a higher range model, like this tower designed in normal range in its local access system, with a link to a curve in large range. If the curve is moved up, the external reference, which is normal range split of the large range curve, updates and updates the tower. Product structure is agile and can be modified. If you copy past a part or a product, even if you change your level in the tree, the position is kept. In fact, it creates new instances with a computed relative position to keep the location in 3D. When a part is designed in context, like this pier segment, you can move it to another location in the tree and synchronize the link with update command. But don't create another instance of a contextual part to avoid having two instances of the same reference and one looking not up to date. Conclusion. Make the preliminary design inside one part, ideate freely, then factorize your model to reuse identical parts and products as much as possible. The product structure should reflect the spatial organization. Use AEC type to be compliant with IFC, geolocation to locate your model on the globe, and large range if your project is bigger than 1 kilometer. You can reorganize the product structure, but make sure the links are always up to date.